Now we'll take some very basic questions where I will give you the parabola and I would ask you to get me various aspects or various critical points and critical equations with respect to this. So find vertex, focus, equation of directrix, equation of directrix, length of the lattice rectum, or let's say equation of axis, equation of axis, length of the lattice rectum, for the following parabolas, for the following parabolas. I'll start with a very basic one. Let's say y square is equal to 8x. Let's say y square is minus x. X square is 16y. X square is minus 8y. So very easy. Just a warm-up kind of a question, and then we'll be going to some deeper concepts. So I'm giving you exactly 2 minutes to complete this. So while you're solving it, let's start the discussion for the first one. So the first one, the vertex is going to be at the origin, right? So I'll keep writing the answers over here as well. Let's change the color. Let me write in blue. Yeah. So vertex for the first one is 0, 0, no doubt about it. Okay. Focus would be at A, 0. Now, what is A over here? 8 is 4A, so A is going to be 2. So focus is going to be at 2, 0. Okay. Equation of the directrix would be x equal to minus a. So x equal to minus 2 would be the equation of the directrix. Okay. Next, what is the equation of the axis? Equation of the axis would be your x axis itself, which is nothing but y equal to 0. Okay. Length of the lattice rectum is normally this number that you see over here. Okay, so 8 units will be your length of the lattice rectum. Or you can say 4A is the length of the lattice rectum. Okay, guys. So no problem in doing the first one. It was super simple. So let me quickly rush through the other parts as well. So let's talk about the second one. Y square is equal to minus X. If possible, make a rough sketch in your mind. Y square is equal to minus x would be like this. Okay. So vertex will still be at 0, 0. Right. For focus, I need to get my A. Now remember here, 4A is 4A is equal to 1 over here. This negative sign only represents its orientation. It only represents the orientation of the parabola. Okay, so 4A is still 1, so A will be 1 by 4. So your focus will be at minus A, 0. Minus A, 0. Equation of the directrix would be x equal to A in this case, which is x equal to 1 by 4. Equation of the axis will still remain the x axis, which is y equal to 0. And the length of the lattice rectum is going to be 1 unit. Length of the lattice rectum is going to be 1 unit in this case. Remember, whatever is the coefficient of x, take mod of it. That is going to be your length of the lattice rectum. So moving on to the third problem, x square is equal to 16y. X square is equal to 16y. Make a rough figure in your mind. It's going to be a parabola opening upwards. Vertex will still be at 0, 0. Correct? Focus would be at 0, comma a. So to know your a, just equate 16 to 4a. So a will be 4. So focus will be at 0, comma a. Equation of the directrix would be y is equal to minus a. Y is equal to minus a. Equation of the axis is going to be your y axis, which is going to be x equal to 0. And length of the lattice rectum is going to be 16, as I have already discussed with you. 16 units would be the length of the lattice rectum. Right? So now moving on to the last problem, x square is equal to minus 8y. So x square is equal to minus 8y is going to be a parabola opening downwards. Okay. However, vertex will continue to be at 0, 0. Okay. Focus would be at 0, minus a. Remember, 4a is 8 over here. So a is 2. So 0, minus a would be 0, minus 2, which is this point. Equation of the directrix will be y is equal to a, which is nothing but y is equal to 2. Equation of the axis is going to be your y axis, which is x equal to 0 line. And length of the lattice rectum is this particular figure over here, which is 8 units. Okay. So by this, we have completed the 8th question as well. Now guys, so far we were talking about such cases of a parabola whose vertex was at origin and whose axes were exactly the x-axis or the y-axis, correct? Those are called standard forms. So what are standard forms? Standard forms are those cases where the vertex is at origin and the axis of the parabola is either your x-axis or your y-axis. Okay. Now we are going to learn something called the generalized form. We are going to learn now the generalized form. When I say generalized form, now the vertex will not be at origin, right? And your axis of the parabola would be parallel to the x-axis or parallel to the y-axis. Okay. So let me draw a typical diagram of a generalized case of a parabola. So let's say this is our y-axis, this is our x-axis. Okay. If I draw a parabola like this, where the vertex is now at some point, let's say h, k, okay, and your axis of the parabola is now parallel to the x-axis like this, okay, then in this case, such a parabola would be called as the generalized form of the parabola. So this is your axis, this is your vertex, right? Now, how does the equation of this parabola change? If you would realize this, it is actually a case of shifting this parabola, right? So this dotted parabola has been shifted to this position, isn't it? Okay. Can somebody tell me if you're shifting a parabola up by, let's say, k units and right by h units, how does the equation change? We have already done this in our bridge course. So when y square is equal to 4ax parabola is shifted h units to the right and let's say k units up, we know that the transformed equation, this gets transformed to y minus k the whole square is equal to 4ax minus h, right? You can also see this concept as shifting of origin. Okay, so if you want your parabola to go up and right, then that in that case you are shifting your origin to minus h minus k. Remember that. Right, in that case you are shifting your origin to minus h comma minus k. So this becomes the equation of a parabola whose vertex is at h comma k, but its axis is still parallel to the x-axis and it's opening towards the right. Is that okay? Now, in a similar way, the rest other equations will also get changed as per what was the orientation of the standard parabola which you were generalizing and where are you shifting the vertex of the parabola. Okay, so I'll take just one more case so that you understand the concept well. So if I say I have drawn a parabola like this. Okay. So this distance is still A. Okay. And the vertex is now at H, K. Right. And this becomes your axis of the parabola. This becomes your axis of the parabola. Okay. In that case, how would you write the equation of the parabola? You would say very simple. The equation of the parabola in this case would become x minus h whole square is minus 4a y minus k. Okay. Now, next, we are going to take up some questions where I will give you a generalized version or a generalized form of a parabola and I would ask you the critical points and critical equations of that parabola. Now, this is something which is beyond your school. In school exam, they will never ask you a generalized version of a parabola. In CBSE curriculum, we are mostly focused or we are mostly catering to the needs of standard case of a parabola. So let's take a question here. Find the vertex. Again, same set, focus, equation of directrix, equation of axis, length of lattice rectum, length of lattice rectum. Okay, for the following parabola, so let me give you a simple one to start with. X y minus 2 the whole square is equal to 16x plus 1. Okay, I would just give half a minute or 1 minute for you to try it out and then I will solve it for you. All right, so I'll just discuss how to attempt such problems. Just try to compare this with y square is equal to 4ax, right? Remember, there is no negative sign over here. So I will not compare it with y square is equal to minus of 4ax, but I will compare it with y square is equal to plus 4ax. Okay. Now, if you directly compare, you would realize your y role is being played by y minus 2. Okay. X role is being played by x plus 1. And 4a role is being played by 16. Correct? Which means your a is going to be 4. Okay, now see the approach for solving this problem. The first problem is we have to find the vertex. Okay, so just make a comparison chart. So on this side, I would write y square is equal to 4ax. On this side, I would write y minus 2 whole square is equal to 4ax. 16, I have written it as 4 into 4. Okay. Now we know for vertex, your x and y both are 0. Right? We know that coordinates of vertex is 0, 0. Isn't it? This is your vertex, which implies both x and y are 0. Now I would do a similar thing on this side as well. That means I would write x plus 1 as 0 and I would write your y minus 2 as 0. Right? Which gives me x value as minus 1 and y value as 2, which means the vertex of this parabola would be at minus 1, 2. Is this clear, guys? So this is going to be my vertex. Okay. Again, second thing is we want to find the focus. We know focus is a comma 0, right? When you say a and 0, it means your capital X is a and your capital Y is 0, right? So this is your capital X and this is your capital Y, correct? So I'm going to do the same role change over here. So I would write capital X as small x plus 1 equal to A. A is 4. And I'm going to write capital Y is Y minus 2 equal to 0 means this is equal to 0. That means X becomes 3, Y becomes 2. That means combine it and make a point out of it. So 3 comma 2 would be the position of the focus. 3 comma 2 would be the position of the focus. Okay. Next is we are asked the equation of the directrix. Okay. So equation of directrix for such case of a parabola y square is equal to 4ax. We know that the equation is x equal to minus a. Right, x equal to minus a. So here also I would say x is x plus 1 minus a is minus 4, which implies x plus 5 equal to 0 becomes the desired directrix. So this becomes the equation of the directrix. Please note it's an equation, just don't write minus 5. This is your directrix. Okay, next is equation of the axis. Equation of the axis. Equation of the axis in this case is y equal to 0 because it's your x axis. So in this case, you would say y minus 2 equal to 0. This becomes your desired equation of the axis of the parabola. Okay. And lastly, we have length of lattice rectum. Length of lattice rectum is given as 4a units. So in this case, it will become 4 into 4, which is 16 units. Okay, so this is your length of lattice rectum. Is it clear? Shreya, Yamini, Aryaman, is it clear? So now guys, you need to respond to the question which I am going to ask you next. So in case of any doubt, please type it on the chat box. In case you are fine with it, please type clear so that I can proceed. All right, so Shreya says yes.